more qualitative. Today, the Meena sir is going to discuss about the quality certification process for gold, silver, and bronze certification to the hospitals under the Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. First of all, sir, we'll start with the presidential address of the Honorable Vice Chancellor, then we will move. Sir, VC sir, please, your presidential address, please.
Sure.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
In this Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana quality certification process, on the behalf of Hemchandracharya North Gujarat University, I welcome all of you. This is a very important process for healthcare, and as we know, it is the largest health assurance scheme in the whole world, and that is why it requires great attention how that the scheme can be beneficial to a large mass, because it comprehensively takes care of need-based persons of the country. And the important motto, as we know, is leave no one behind. Nobody should be left. So that is why this Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana is very important, and we should know more details about this Yojana. Fortunately, we are having two renowned speakers, Dr. J.L. Meena from Delhi and Dr. Kartik Shah from Gandhinagar. Both are prominent speakers, and they will be speaking in detail. Now, I would like to draw the attention of the gathering, the example of Dharavi, Mumbai. As we know, Dharavi is a very, very thickly populated area in which it is very difficult to survive without infection from others. But still, 2 days back, as it was reported, Dharavi had only one new case. You can imagine the population that is highest in the Asia continent, only one case. Whereas if one realizes that 10 or 15 cases in a moderate city, it creates panic, and people used to afraid of going elsewhere in the market and so on. That is why we can understand, because they very strictly followed the government suggestions of putting on the mask, of keeping the social distance, and frequently hand sanitization. We have heard and seen a number of times from various government agencies regarding all these three things and avoiding social gathering. But still, I don't know, the fear of COVID-19 has almost vanished, but the number of cases, looking to the overall country position, they are on increase. Still, we don't find the plateau, and that is why we have to strictly make use of all these three practices on a compulsory basis. Only then and then the corona pandemic will be relieved. So with that simple request, I congratulate Dr. K.K. Patel and the faculty members of Hospital Management Department of Hemchandracharya North Gujarat University for
thank you sir
organizing this beautiful event. And I am sure that the deliberations will be helpful to all of you. So once again, congratulating all of you. Thank you, and back to the host.
Thank you very much, sir, for guiding us. And I start with the address by Dr. D.L. Meena, sir. We are thankful to you that you worked a lot for the health department of government of Gujarat also. We have attended your workshop and seminars. Even you work hard for development of the health sector. So we are very much thankful to you. Presently, you are working with Government of India. You are having a wide experience. So, sir, please address the audience. Around 56 audience is connected now. So, please, sir.
Okay. Thank you, Patel sir and Bora sir. Good afternoon to everybody. Before I start, I want to know that what is quality? When we say for the quality, quality is a common sense, just like a right work at the right time for the right clients by the right provider with the satisfaction is known as quality. But when we say for the quality in health sectors, the quality means standard environment, standard treatment, and standards behaviors. And last but not least, satisfaction for both provider as well as client, known as the quality. और जे आपने सबसे सिंपल भाषा में कही है कि जे आपने जो ये ए बीजा ने आपो दैट मींस क्वालिटी नथिंग मोर देन दिस तो आपने जो एकदम गुजराती नहीं प्योर भाषा छे कि जे आपने जो ये ए बीजा ने आपो दैट मींस क्वालिटी बिकॉज़ वी नो एज ए पेशेंट व्हाट इज योर एक्सपेक्टेशन एंड यू वांट दिस एक्सपेक्टेशन यू प्रोवाइड ऑल द एक्सपेक्टेशन टू द क्लाइंट्स इज नोन एज क्वालिटी तो क्वालिटी इज जस्ट ए कॉमन सेंस But when we say for the quality, quality is coming from your heart. It's not coming just like a order and other things. It's coming from your heart. When you realize the quality from your heart, you will provide quality from your heart. And then it's really needed for quality from your heart. And another thing is important thing is that quality is never achieved by a single person. It's a teamwork. When surgeons do waist surgery, but housekeeping is not proper, you can't prevent infections. If nursing is not proper, you can't cure. If pharmacist is not proper, you can't cure. And that's why the quality is that teamwork. It's never achieved by a single person. And it's a continuous learning process. It is the continuous improvement process. You know that the DNA between the chimpanzee and the human beings, 99% are same, only the difference between the 1%. If God cannot think for the quality, then you never human being is coming because From chimpanzee to humans, only 1% in difference. And that's why the quality is very necessary, or especially in the health sectors. 1% can cause morbidity and mortality. One error can cause morbidity and mortality. And that's why quality is needed 100%. And in the Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, ji apna vishwani sabthi sarkari sansthama jo sabthi mota moti chhe apne आयुष्मान भारत प्रधानमंत्री जन आरोग्य योजना इसमें जो आपने क्वालिटी नहीं बात करी है तो एक खूब स्टैंडर्ड तरीके से आपने क्वालिटी हम इंप्लीमेंट करी है सबसे पहले तो एबीपीएमजे क्वालिटी सर्टिफिकेशन प्रोसेस वी आर जस्ट प्रोवाइड द एबीपीएमजे क्वालिटी सर्टिफिकेशन प्रोसेस फॉर द कंटिन्यूस क्वालिटी इंप्रूवमेंट प्रोग्राम द एबीपीएमजे क्वालिटी सर्टिफिकेशन प्रोसेस इज द थ्री डिफरेंट लेवल्स फर्स्ट इज द ब्रॉन्ज क्वालिटी सर्टिफिकेशन Second is the silver quality certifications. And third is the gold quality certifications, means the topmost quality certifications. If you see the quality certifications, it's a three levels. Which hospital, does not have the NABH, NABL, or NQAS certified hospitals without any accreditation or certified hospitals, the hospital goes to the bronze quality certificate. So bronze means it's a minimum quality standards in the Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. If any hospital have the NQAS certified or NABH entry levels, go for the silver quality certifications. If your hospital is the NABH full accreditation or JCI accreditations, go for the gold quality certifications. So these are the process which is the continuous improvement and grading the quality of care. If it's launched, bronze quality certification is launched in the August 2019. It's just a pre-entry level certifications. Through the quality certification if your hospital is not impaneled with the Ayushman Bharat, but you go for the quality certifications, bronze quality certification, and if you receive the bronze quality certifications, your hospital directly impaneled with the Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, if you want to impanel it. So that means is the second line for the impanelment. NABH certified hospital directly impaneled with the Ayushman Bharat if hospital want bronze quality certification. If they want to impanel with Ayushman Bharat, they directly impanel with Ayushman Bharat. So bronze quality certification is just a entry level quality certifications standard. We know over 75% of the SSCs is in tier 2 and tier 3 level cities, and they are not entry level or NQAS because of the quality certification, because of the lack of infrastructure and other things, and that's why we minimize quality standards like the bronze quality certification standards. If you see the bronze quality certification standards, hospital which does not have the NQAS, NABH or JCI accredited certification go for the bronze quality certification. Hospitals which is already impaneled with Ayushman Bharat go for the bronze quality certification. If hospital does not impaneled with Ayushman Bharat and want to bronze quality certification, they are also go for the bronze quality certification, and after getting the bronze quality certification, they are directly impaneled with the Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. So no need for the district verification and state verification. They directly impaneled with the Ayushman Bharat if they have the bronze quality certifications. In the bronze quality certification is the 53 standards and 182 means of verifications, including the input related, clinical input, supportive services, patient care and healthcare outcomes. So the five chapter is there, and in the five chapter, 53 standards, 182 means of verification is there. The process of the bronze quality certification means your hospital go for the registration on the portal if your hospital is impaneled. If your hospital is not impaneled, then your hospital directly go to the ABPMJ websites and login ID and registers. Then information document and submission means we are main focus when we say for the quality. I think self-assessment is the best assessment for the quality improvement. Just a simple questions. अगर हमसे ये कहा जाए कि हम दूसरों की कमियां बताएं, तो मेरे को लग रहा है हमें लाइन लग जाएगी, दूसरों की कमी निकालने में तो हम बहुत ही एक्सपर्ट हैं। लेकिन अगर हमें ये कहा जाए कि आप में अपनी कितनी कमियां हैं, तो लाइन बहुत छोटी हो जाएगी, क्योंकि हमें कभी भी अपनी कमियां नहीं दिखती है। एंड दैट्स वाई वी आर फोकस ऑन ओनली द सेल्फ असेसमेंट। फर्स्ट यू रियलाइज दैट व्हाट इज योर स्ट्रेंथ, व्हाट इज योर वीकनेस, व्हाट इज योर अपॉर्चुनिटी, व्हाट इज योर थ्रेट, देन यू इम्प्रूव द क्वालिटी। If you don't realize your weakness, opportunity, threat and strength, then it's difficult to improve your quality. And that's why we are focused on the self-assessment. And according to the self-assessment, you give the evidence on the according to the 182 verifications. Then fee payment. Yes, bronze quality certification standard have a minimum fees which goes to the Quality Council of India. And it's very minimized, up to 10,000 to 30,000. If your hospital is 50 bedded, then 10,000. If your hospital is more than 1,000 bedded, then maximum 30,000 fees is there. After the fees, you provide the fees and self-assessment, your desktop assessment is going by the qualified assessors from the Quality Council of India. Desktop assessment is totally online assessment. And that's why if you give proper evidence in the self-assessment toolkit, then your desktop assessment is done. If your desktop assessment is successful, you are again on-site assessment is coming by and qualified assessors from the Quality Council of India coming for the on-site assessment. If your on-site assessment is successful, then your certification is received on your registered mail ID. That means this certificate is totally online. If your hospital is prepared very well, you will get this within 25 days, within 25 days. And without any manual phone or thing, it's totally IT based, totally online process, registrations, self-assessment, desktop assessment, on-site assessment, and after the successful of the on-site and desktop assessment, you will get certification on your registered mail ID. If your desktop assessment, first desktop assessment is not successful, then again NC is raised. You compliance this NC, then second desktop assessment is done. If your second desktop assessment is successful, then again on-site assessment. if your both desktop assessment means two desktop assessment is not successful, then you will go again re-registration. Because in the bronze quality certification, the maximum desktop assessment is two. If your two desktop assessment is not successful, then you again go for the registrations. And that's why before you go for the bronze quality certification or silver or gold quality certification, your preparedness is very important. And that's why if you are well prepared, then you will get this within 25 days. This is the just roadmap. The website is there, AVPMJ websites. You see the websites, the registration portal. If your hospital is not impaneled with the Ayushman Bharat and want to impaneled, so you first get to the bronze quality certification and then directly impaneled with the Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. Same thing in the non-impaneled hospitals, registration on the portals, pay a fees, then fill your application from the self-assessment toolkit. After the self-assessment, desktop assessment is coming. Desktop assessment, on-site assessment is coming. After successful of the on-site assessment, you get the bronze quality certification on your registered ID. After you receive bronze quality certification, if you want to impanel with the ABPMJ, you will just click and impanel with the ABPMJ. You are enjoyed with your bronze quality certifications. This is for the silver and gold quality certifications. For the silver and gold quality certification, they just a rename of the already accredited certification. Like the silver quality certification is for the entry level NABH accreditation and NQAS national level certifications. If your hospital is already have the NQAS national level certification or NABH certification, go for the silver quality certifications. If your hospital is NABH full accredited or JCI accredited, go for the gold quality certifications. Because we know in the NABH entry level and NABH NQAS national level or NABH full or JCI accreditation, once the inspection team is coming, after that 1.5 years or 3 years, after 3 years again team is coming. So for the continuous quality improvement, we need some type of the certification, just like a silver or gold quality certifications. They in the silver and gold quality certificates, there will be no fees, because you already give fees in the NQAS NABH and entry level or JCI accreditation. That's so that the in the silver and gold quality certificate, there will be no fees. And a very simple process, because your hospital is already impaneled with Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, just you go and log in the HEM portals. Then the again self-assessment is there. Here the 45 question is there in the silver quality certification and same 45 questions for the gold quality certifications. In the 45 questions, 20 question is the self-assessment toolkit. Because when we say the quality, again I say the self-assessment is the best assessment for the improvement. And that's why we realize that the self-assessment toolkit is very necessary. And in the self-assessment toolkit, we have the 20 questions. For the self-assessment toolkits, you give the proper evidence of the self-assessment toolkits, and then the 25 questions, they are the ABPMJ specific questions that your hospital is the already accredited, but are your hospital is provide better quality services in the ABPMJ beneficiaries? Are you have the IC material of the ABPMJ? Are your desktop is available? The multiple questions like the 25 question is there. And if you give the proper evidence according to the assessment, then your desktop assessment is done by the qualified assessors. Again, here the two desktop assessment is there. If your first desktop assessment is not successful, the second desktop assessment is there. If your second desktop assessment is not successful, then again you re-registered, because only maximum chance is the two desktop assessment. After your successful desktop assessment, you directly received certifications on your registered mail ID. In the gold and the silver quality certification, there will be no on-site assessment, because your hospital is already NABH entry level or NQAS certified or NABH or JCI. That's why in the silver and gold quality certification, there will be no on-site assessment. There will be no any fees structures. And you get the silver and gold quality certifications. A very simple process within 7 days. If your hospital is well prepared, you will get within 7 days gold or silver quality certification. How to achieve? It's a very important question. How to achieve gold and silver quality certifications? Same, you know, the gold quality certification, if your hospital is NABH full accredited or JCI accredited, registered answer of the questions means self-assessment, desktop assessment, and after desktop assessment, you will change certification on your registered mail ID. This is the gold quality certification with the scope of services and with the expiry date of the same expiry date of the NABH entry level or NQAS for NABH full accreditations. Same for the quality certifications, the process is same, registers on your portal, ABPMJ specific questions, about 45 questions is there. The document verification by the desktop assessment by the qualified assessor from the Quality Council of India, and then certificate is online certification goes to your registered mail ID. This is the silver quality certification, the same process, the scope of services and hospital with the expiry date. The question is very specific. Here you see the ABPMJ specific question about 25. If you see this certifications where the 25 question is there, and some self-assessment toolkit 20 question is also available on quality audit checklist. So you fulfill all the 25 questions and self-assessment toolkit 20 questions. If you give proper answer of all 45 questions, then your desktop assessment is done, and after desktop assessment, your certification is received within 7 days. And in the 25 questions, the last 25 question is the completion of your quality audit checklist. That means after completion of the quality audit checklist, please submit and take a screenshot. And this screenshot should be uploaded as a evidence of the ABPMJ specific question number 25. Means when you apply for the silver or gold quality certification, please first you fill the quality audit checklist 20 questions. After filling and submit the 20 questions, you take the screenshot and this evidence for the last 25 question. After that, you give the evidence of the 25 question, 1 to 25 question. The question is there, and they are also want the evidence for the self-assessment. If you see the question, what is the question of the ABPMJ gold and silver quality certifications, like the ABPMJ basic and self-assessment toolkits. You see the first question, are your scope of service registered under ABPMJ clearly defined and displayed prominent place? Means if your hospital is already impaneled, but if your hospital is impaneled, but your scope of service is not displayed, then how the know the beneficiary that your hospital is impaneled or services available or not? And that's why your hospital is impaneled with Ayushman Bharat. Kindly clearly define the scope of services and display at prominent place with the local language. In the Gujarati, Gujarati is the first. In the Hindi rast, Hindi is also first. Another language, the English is also there. The scope of service registered under the ABPMJ display while lingual. While lingual means one is the local language, another is the Hindi or English. It's depend on you. Is the hospital star aware the scope of services? It's also very important question when the beneficiary is coming. If your staff is not knowing the scope of service, then it's difficult to give the services for the beneficiary. And that's why, are your staff is know for the scope of services? And for the knowing the scope of services, your staff is well trained. And for the training evidence, you give as evidence on these questions. Same, is there the dedicated kiosk or counter is there? If your kiosk is not there, again, the beneficiary is difficult to find any counters and other things. And that's why your dedicated kiosk or counter is available or not. Is the kiosk counter managed by the Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Mitra? Trained staff during the operational hours. Means, are you have the Arogya Mitra? Because Arogya Mitra is very helpful for the beneficiaries. And that's why we need proper, well-trained Arogya Mitra at the kiosk. The question 6, are you required the equipment provided by Arogya Mitra for ABPMJ beneficiaries identification? Means, are you have the proper computer for the Arogya Mitra? Are you have the proper cameras for Arogya Mitra? Are you have the proper net? That's why the identification of the beneficiary, that his name is in ABPMJ or not, or are the Arogya Mitra is well trained or not. Does the hospital have the dedicated team for the ABPMJ? Yes. Means ABPMJ team means one is the Arogya Mitra, another is the medical doctors, another is the administrative staff. That your team is well or not. If you do not have the proper teams, then it's very difficult for the beneficiaries. The question 8, does your hospital have at least one Pradhan Mantri Arogya Mitra dedicated person perceived approval for the looking after the work of Ayushman Bharat Jan Arogya Yojana. If your hospital is 24/7, then 100% your Arogya Mitra should be more than one, because one person cannot cannot service 24/7, and that's why we need the shifting according to the shift, 2 or 3. Does your nominated ABPMJ team have the doctors? Doctor is very important, because in the ABPMJ's 1353 process is there, and which is totally in the medical terminology, and that's why the doctor is needed for ABPMJ's. Does the nominated ABPMJ team have member from the administration department? Yes, administration is very important. Some of the administration problems, then the administration is also required. Means the ABPMJ teams, your first is the arogometer is there or not. Second is the doctor is there or not. Third is the administration staff is there or not. When you upload your evidence, that means the name of the doctors or appointment letter of the doctors, appointment letter of the arogomet, appointment letter of the administration department, and with the scope of services, just like a Pradhan Mantri arogomet, doctors and administration. Then the desktop assessment is successful. For the 11th question, if you see the ABPMJ IEC material, when we say that for the IEC, IEC means information, education, and communication. But I think in the most of the areas, IEC means information enter in the corner. Most of the IEC materials is just put in the corners, and that's a very difficult task. And that's why humble request that your proper IEC is there or not in the understanding language. So is available, you take the photo and this photo put as evidence. Does your ABPMJ counter have the IC material pertaining to the ABPMJ or near it? Same thing. Hospital conduct any promotional activity like camping or spreading awareness regarding the ABPMJ schemes. Your hospital is already impaneled with Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. Are your hospital is promote some activity like the camping that this hospital is impaneled with Ayushman Bharat Yojana, and it's benefits to the SECC data beneficiaries. So are you camping? If camping, you give, take the photo and take as evidence on your questions. Your hospital scope of service mapped with the hospital manpower and human resource. It's very important questions, because you, when you say that scope of services this, but according to the scope of services, are you have the manpower? Are you have the human resource? Are you have the infrastructures? And accordingly, according to the scope of service, means if you say that you provide physical or medical services, then physician must. If you say the surgery is to provide, then surgeon is must. If you say the gynecological services, means gynecologist is must. And according to, you give the evidence, one side scope of services, another side the scope of name of the manpowers with the qualifications. Does your hospital maintain proper medical record maintained by the ABPMJ patients? If your ABPMJ beneficiary is coming, are your hospital is properly maintain your medical records, means the registrations, OPD, IPD, diagnostic facility, discharge summary is available or not? The ABPMJ claim process, yes, are your claim proper claim process is there or not? If you have the proper claim process policy, you give as evidence. Does your hospital charge any extra money for the ABPMJ beneficiary? It's very important questions, because when we say for the ABPMJ beneficiary, and ABPMJ is the totally free of cost. If you hear, the answer is only yes or no. But if you say, does your hospital charge any extra money? If you say yes, means your hospital is not service. Money from the beneficiary. So that if you say answer no, then it's a correct answer. It's very important, does your hospital charge any extra money or not? That means no. Are the deployed staff members trained for the HEM portal here? The MCQ question is there. You go for this questions. One MCQ question is there. You put right answers and signed, and after that you screen, and according to the screen you upload. If your staff is well trained and be on the desktop assessment that your answer is correct, then you are successful. If your answer is not correct, then the NC is rise. Same in the TMS portals, Are your deployed staff members trained for the TMS portal? When you go for these questions, one question paper is coming, and just multiple choice questions. You give the proper answers and signed by the trained staffs, and then upload, and according to uploaded, desktop assessment is coming. Same question paper at the BIS portal also. Your question number saying, does the hospital maintain proper the ABPM, the referral benefits? Yes. Referral, when we say for the referral is very important. That your hospital is referred to this impaneled hospital, and you say that your beneficiary is reached safely in this hospital or not. So according to the record, you give the evidence. The number of the ABPMJ beneficiary referred to the ABPMJ hospital in last 6 months. In the last 6 months, how many beneficiaries you referred to the another hospitals? If you don't refer, you please give the nil. Number of the ABPMJ inpatient censored for the last 6 months means inpatient IP. Just a number. Does the hospital collect feedback during the discharge from the ABPM beneficiaries? If you have the discharge process, if you have the discharge feedback form, you screen the feedback form and upload as evidence. The ABPMJ quality audit checklist. The last question, ABPMJ quality audit checklist filled regularly in HEM portal. Means before you go for the bronze, silver quality certifications or gold quality certification, you filled the quality audit checklist first. And after you filled quality audit checklist first, 20 questions is there, then you submit. And after submitting, you take a screenshot, and this screenshot you give evidence in the last 25 questions that your ABPMJ quality audit checklist filled regularly in HEM portal. If you complete all these 25 questions in the self-assessment and give proper evidence, then your desktop assessment is going by the qualified NABH assessors from the Quality Council of India. And after the successful desktop assessment, you will get gold or silver quality certifications on your registered email ID. I think this is very important. The question is very reasonable, very simple. Just evidence. Just if you give proper evidence, you are successful. If you don't give proper evidence, then again it's the problems. It's the maximum period, the 7 days. Within 7 days, you will get silver or gold quality certifications. For the guideline of the quality audit checklist, same. The quality audit checklist is 20 parameter. The assessment of the quality audit checklist is depend on the four means the direct observation, means the patient review, in the staff review, and in the record review. Here the 20 question is there because your hospital is already NABH entry level or NQAS or NABH full or JCI accredited. That's why we know that your hospital is continuously quality improvement or one time quality improvement. And that's why we give the 20 questions. Like, are your services provide ABPMJ impaneled hospital patient right and responsibility are clearly defined displayed at the prominent place or not? Hospital IC material is prominent place or not? Initial assessment by the doctor and patient document within 24 hours. And the patient record file clear the treatment order, which is signed, name, time, dated by the concerned doctor or not. The result of the diagnostic laboratory or radiology test made available within defined time frame or not. The critical time alert is or immediately is available or not. During the cardiopulmonary resuscitations, the mock drill conducted or properly or not, or regular interval sequence CPR pictorial manuals should be displayed or not. If you go, the pictorious guideline is also available on hospitalpmj.gov.in. The six questions, the regular periodic monitoring of anesthesia component, like recording of the heart rate, cardiac rate, respiratory rate, blood pressure, oxygen saturations, airway saturations, patency, and anesthesias. The informed consent duly signed by the informed risk, beneficiaries, alternatives, consent doctors or not. WHO checklist, because it prevents the wrong site, wrong patient, and wrong surgery. So follow the WHO safety checklist or not. The document procedure for the manage of the medications is very important due to the prevent the medical errors. And that's why we that management of medications are defined and implemented. Like sound alike, look alike medications are stored separately or not. Listing and storage of the high risk medications to be done and order should be verified before their dispensing. If you see the 11 question, the verification of the dose, route, timing, expiry date before administration of medication should be done or not. Adverse drug events are corrected analysis by the treating doctor and practices are modified to reduce the same and the hospital infection control committee. Committee means it's not on paper, it should be a functional committee. It's considered the functional and defined surveillance and tracking the analysis of the hospital acquired infections. Because it's a very important during this pandemic situations, I think hospital acquired infection is very important role for prevent the other infections. All the healthcare providers should have the easily accessible to hand the hand washing practices. We know that 85% is prevented by proper hand washing practices. And that's why the are your staff members are properly hand washing practices or properly trained or not. The staff members should provide the adequate appropriate pre and post exposure prophylaxis is also very important to during this pandemic situations. The proper medical waste management. You all know that in the MODAS, after the MODAS incidents, I think the drastic change is coming in all over India after in the biomedical waste segregation. And that's why it's very important. When we say for the proper biomedical waste management, I think segregation is the important point, and segregation is the responsibility of all staff. And segregation at the source is a very important part. And that's why the biomedical waste management properly or not. The defined mechanism, regular updating of the license, registration, and certification and MOU. It's very important things because your license is expired or not, registration is expired or not, and certifications. So you give the list of the licenses, expiry date. The self-exit plan, fire is a very important features, and that's why you are fire mock drill. How to prevent fire? The mock drill is very important. So it's ongoing process. So your fire mock drill is proper or not, your instrument equipment is not, that is important things. The service provider, the medical professional means credential and privileges according to the nursing staff, according to doctors and others. Up to date chronological data of the patient's care available in the medical record means chronological means first OPD, then the indoor, then the investigation process, then discharge summaries. Accordingly, your chronological detail is available in medical record or not. Only the 20 question is medical audit checklist is there, but the 20 question is covered all NABH, NQAS or NABH entry level certification. If you fill this checklist in regularly monthly basis, I think you create the quality culture, and that's why we want quality culture rather than the inspection. And that's why we say self-assessment is the best assessment, and our main purpose is create quality culture in our impaneled hospitals. So these are the silver and gold quality certification, the 25 question and 24 the quality audit checklist, and the bronze quality certification, because bronze is totally a different standards. It's if you say for the bronze quality certification, if your hospital is not NQAS, NABH, JCI, then you go for the bronze quality certification. In the bronze quality certification, important thing is this, that you will get certification within 25 days if your preparation is well. If your preparation is not well, then again a question mark. But you will get the certification within 25 days. And it's totally transparent. First, you give the proper self-assessment. If your self-assessment is best, your desktop assessment is also online assessment. That's why the transparency is there. And after the online assessment of the desktop assessment, your on-site assessment is already on the web-based assessment. And that's why the each and everything is transparent. There will be no manually problems, and your certification is received on your registered mail ID within 25 days. So the certification process is same, registrations, information in self-assessment, fees, the minimum fees is there in the bronze quality certification, but in the silver and gold, there will be no fees. The desktop assessment done by the qualified assessors. In the first desktop assessment, if your first desktop was not successful, then NC is raised, then the second desktop assessment. And after successful, the second desktop assessment, your on-site assessment. But if your desktop assessment, two desktop assessment is not successful, then again, you read registrations. And after on-site assessment successful, you get the certification. If any NC is raised in the on-site assessment, you will compliance the on-site assessment NCs, and then you will get the certification also. The certification is gold, both impaneled hospital as well as the non-impaneled hospital. If you are a non-impaneled hospital and want to bronze certification, you go for the bronze quality certification. And after you getting the bronze quality certification, if you want to impanel with the ABPMJ, you will directly impanel with the ABPMJ. So it's a very simple process for the impanelment also. And the branch quality certification, why this needed for the branch quality certification? Because we know in the tier 3 and tier 4 cities, the branch quality certification is the minimum quality standards. And that's why we want minimum quality standards to create quality cultures. The national wide recognized, because this certification given by the national, and that's why the national wide recognition there. Increased credibility of the health provider 100%. If your hospital get the branch quality certification, the national branch quality certification means your credibility is increased. Patient safety and increased care of the patient. Because it is a quality certifications and focus on the quality process, and that's why the patient safety is also important. You see the chapters, the five chapters is there. The standard 53 standard is there, means of verification 182. You see the chapters like the key input, clinical services, supportive services, patient care, healthcare outcomes. And if you see the standards 53 standard is there, and different standards, the verification, means of verification is also there. The key input, if you see the chapter one, here the 10 key elements is standard is there. You see the physical facilities, hospitals should be adequate to space, ambulance or not, hospital provided without the physical barrier or friendly people or not, indoor outdoor area facilities, basic elements of the hospitals, medical staff adequately or not, credential is not, the functional equipment means you have the instrument equipment, are they functional or not, and fire plan process or not, CPR is proper or not, or annual training plan is not. A very simple standard is there in the chapters. If you see the chapter two, the clinical services, here the 11 standard is there, like the patient privacy should be maintained in outpatient department or inpatient, the lab diagnostic services, outsourced or insourced, blood bank services is available or not, hospital should be radiation safety, ARV certification or not, ICU available or not, OT complexity, on the regular requirements is available or not, lookalike, sound-alike medications, means management of the medication is proper or not, identification, safe dispensing administration during the high-risk medication means two times check or not, the facility defined the stabilized antibiotic policy is very important things, the pre-operative, intraoperative, and post-operative should be done by the documentations, or the pre-anesthetic assessment, type of anesthesia, and post-anesthesia status of the documented or not. If you see the chapter three is the totally supportive services, like your hospital is neat and clean, which is very important during this pandemic situations. The temperature control in the ICU, ventilation, OT, the hospital should be arranged with water storage, proper facility or not, periodically check or not. The hospital should have the 24-hourly electric supply or not, medical cases available or not, should practice specify the statutory compliance, the scope of licenses, certification or available or not, infection control practices proper or not, why medical waste management properly protects or not, and housekeeping services, laundry and other dietary services or not, or CSSD available or not, sexual harassment committee or grievance handling process proper or not. The patient care chapters is also have the 11 standard, like your uniform care services or not, proper signages with display, bilingual available or not, your medical care staff should be nearly available, emergency department available or not, inquiry over the patient load, according to the patient load, your staff is available or not, admission of the patient process is available or not, another facility on clinical informations, in case of the non-availability of the services or bed, what is your procedures, consent form like the informed consent, general consent with the benefits, alternative and other things is available or not, user charges, if you take the user charges, it should be a display. But in the Ayushman beneficiary, there will be no user charges by the Ayushman beneficiary because the ABPM is totally free of cost. The patient should be properly educated on the additional care demand required with the vital information according to record of continuous care or not. The hospital should ensure that all medication or assessor instructions written in the prescription and medical records should be maintained properly or not. The last but not least, it's totally outcome. But when we say for the input and process, if your input and process is well defined and well maintained, then your outcome is coming. Outcome means the OPD, IPD, mortality rate, surgical site infections, urinary tract infection, bloodstream infection, ventilator associated pneumonia, or hospital acquired pneumonia, transfusion reaction, bed occupancy, percentage of the patient satisfaction, percentage of the employee satisfaction, waiting times, reporting of the adverse events, reporting the threats or security related incident, reporting the needleistic injuries. So these are outcomes which also need as evidence. You see, we also have the desktop for the ABPMJ quality certificates. This is a desktop picture of the 22 May. Here the all the gold quality certification, silver quality certification, bronze quality certificate, total applications, total application is in process, and the desktop assessment in the draft process, and with the detail of the hospitals is there. So it's totally transparent. The important things in this ABPMJ quality certification, one is the important is it's mainly focused on the self-assessment. And we 100% think that if you think your self-assessment is excellent, you'll never fail in desktop assessment or on-site assessment. Because we need quality culture. We need self-assessment toolkit. We don't want that koi aaye aur hame galtiyan bata ke chala jaye. Hum chahte hain ki aap apni galti khud nikalein aur khud improvement kare. And that's why we need the self-assessment. If your self-assessment go good, your desktop assessment is good. Your desktop assessment is good, your on-site assessment is good. And the another important feature is totally online, a totally online process. There will be no manual process. So jo hame problems aati hai sabse zyada ki bhaiya mera desktop assessment ho gaya, main phone kar raha hu aur waah ki kab mera certificate aayega, kab kya hoga, kab NC complete hogi, wo sara kuch yahan pe khatam kar diya gaya hai. Yahan pe clear hai aapka self assessment, clear hai आपको अपना पता लग जाएगा. आप अगर ट्रैक करोगे, जैसे ही लॉगिन आईडी करोगे, आपको पता लगेगा कि मेरा हॉस्पिटल डेस्कटॉप असेसमेंट के पहले फेज पे है, मेरा हॉस्पिटल डेस्कटॉप असेसमेंट के सेकंड फेज पे है, या मेरा हॉस्पिटल ऑन साइट असेसमेंट आने के फेज पे है, या सक्सेसफुल ऑन साइट असेसमेंट होगा तो मेरा जो सर्टिफिकेट आएगा उसके लिए भी कहने की जरूरत नहीं है. जैसे ही आपका ऑन साइट असेसमेंट सक्सेसफुल हुआ, आपका तैयारी में सक्सेसफुल आपका सर्टिफिकेशन आ जाएगा, वो भी आपकी रजिस्टर्ड मेल आईडी पे. तो टोटली ट्रांसपेरेंट. सेकंड इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज टाइम बाउंड. Within 25 days, if you are well prepared, within 25 days you will get the bronze quality certification. Within 7 days you will get the silver and gold quality certification. So very important things that you will receive certificates within 7 to 25 days, and it's totally transparent manner. There will no phone ki kisi ko phone karne ki zarurat hai ya kisi assessor ki chamchagiri karne ki zarurat hai ki na. Yahan pe totally transparent and totally evidence based hai. If you want the more detail, I think here each and every website is there. pmjquality.org is all the website is there, all the guideline is there, and most of the guideline is totally pictorious guideline. If I just say that this guideline is totally it's totally pictorious guideline, it's very easy to understand. If you go for this website, it's totally pictorious guideline of all 182 verification, that which evidence you want to give for the certifications. So thank you very much, and thanks to Patan University, Bora sir, and Mr. Patels to give this opportunity.
Thank you very much, sir, for sharing your valuable time. We know you are busy in your assignments, but we are very much thankful to you, sir, for sparing your valuable time to us. Now, sir, I would like to invite Dr. Kartik Asha to address the participant. Yes, Dr. Kartik Shah.
Yes, yes. Dr. Meena sir. Dr. Meena. We have worked for this for NABH, for NPS also, and we are also trying for ABPMJ certification also.
Good.
Initiative taken by our own Meena sir, and almost all the points are included in the lecture. And I have also heard this lecture again when we had this meeting with our JY nodal officers and PMJY DPCs also. We had one meeting. We are also trying for the same in our government system. And this is much more helpful to the people who are in the private sector. And because of this, whenever they will go for the certificate, they will benefit a lot more. So from the audience who are going to serve for even public sector or even private sector, this will help in the future. Even during this time of COVID, this desktop assessment, when well, there will be no need of any assessor or no need of presence. This will help a lot. So all the guidance given by our minister is a very good thing for all our state, and we will try to implement. And I also hope that people from HNGU also will learn a lot, will help us a lot. Thank you very much, sir.
Karthik sir, you are heading the quality department of government of Gujarat. Quality certification is under which stage at Gujarat?
Sir, in quality certification, sir, in National Quality Assurance Standards, we have achieved 72 facilities nationally certified, and 852 three facilities last year we have state certified. And in the present year, sir, we have already applied for 44 primary health centers for national level certification. And at national level, last year we achieved 36 facilities for Lakshya certification. This year also we have applied for one facility, and even this for PMJY, we have four district hospitals which we tried for it, but due to some reason we were not able to achieve this certificate in PMJY also. Otherwise, that is also we are trying in our public sector, sir.
Yes, sir. Meena sir, please. We are going for NABH accreditation, and on the other side, we are going for PMJY quality certification process. So, we would like to understand what is the difference between these two.
ABPMJ quality certification and NABH. I clearly defined that if you go for the gold quality certification, your hospital should be NABH full accredited or JCI accredited. Yes. Without NABH accreditation, you cannot apply for the gold quality certifications.
Yeah,
if you apply for silver quality certification, means your hospital should be an NCLAS certified hospital or NABH entry level. But if your hospital is does not have the NCLAS, NABH or JCI, then you go for the bronze quality certification. Means bronze quality certification is the lower standard rather than the entry level or NABH full accreditation. It's a minimum standard which is required for the tier 3 and tier 4 cities hospitals also. So it's a very simple level minimum standards, about 182 means of verification is there. And in case all the certifications, only it's totally online process. The important thing is totally online process. In the gold and silver, only the self-assessment and desktop assessment is there. In the bronze, the desktop assessment, self-assessment and on-site assessment is there. That is the time-bound manner. You will get silver and gold quality certification within 7 days. And there is any certification which will be get within this timeline. Any other
questions? Sir, we are very much thankful that we have gone through the portal, developed a very good portal for PMJY. But sir, basically we have how many gold certificates are issued till date? Any hospital who received a gold certificates in India?
Yes, about 64 gold certificates already received. You go for the website.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Okay, sir. Sir, it's really a great initiative for continuous quality improvement of the healthcare sector. And we are very much thankful to you and authorities, state authorities also. We have many participants from Government of Gujarat. I see Dr. Pradyuman C. Rathod is there from Commissioner of, he is working with the Commissioner of Health. Dr. Dipti Manwar is there. She is also working with the Karthik sir. Dr. Mukesh Jadhav is there. He is a project officer under NHM. We have many people from medical colleges. Dr. Hirpara sir, Dr. Sharma, and Dr. Chintan Rawal from Dharpur Medical College. I would like to, yes, Pradyuman C. Are you online? Pradyuman C. Dr. Pradyuman C. Dr. Pradyuman C. Any person from government of Gujarat? Yeah. Hello. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, Dr. Dipti Manwar.
Oh, good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, Dr. Dipti. Please
switch on your camera. Yes, sir. This is very interactive session, and we have already welcomed Dr. Meena sir also. And in Gujarat, quality is जो pioneer कहते हैं ना कि base Meena sir ही है जो बोलते हैं ना quality is a continuous process. And currently under Kartik sir के under भी हम लोग quality में बहुत अच्छा सा काम कर रहे हैं. और क्वालिटी कंटिन्यूअस इंप्रूवमेंट हो वही हमारा एम है. एंड सर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ हॉस्पिटल मैनेजमेंट जो हेमचंदा चरणौत गुजरात यूनिवर्सिटी में अभी जो पूरे स्टूडेंट अभी अटेंड कर रहे हैं, तो आई एम वेरी लकी कि आई एम अ पायोनियर विद स्टूडेंट ऑफ दिस इंस्टीट्यूट. एंड आई विश ऑल स्टूडेंट्स provide the quality care services in all healthcare services.
Thank you very much, Dr. Dipti. Any other student, Dr. Pradyumanji, are you online?
Can I say something?
Hello.
Yeah. Can I say something?
Yeah, sir. Very much. We are very much thankful to you.
Yes.
I would like to invite Dr. Palak. She is our student, so she will share her views. Yeah, Dr. Palak. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You share your views regarding that. Yeah.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
She is a MBBS and doing hospital administration.
Very good.
Yes. And she also work with the government of Gujarat and Darpur Medical College also. So having experience. Yes, Dr. Palak.
Sir, first of all, I am very thankful to Dr. J.N. Meena sir and Dr. Kartik sir, and for providing the information regarding Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana quality control.
Palak, aapki aawaz nahi aa rahi bhai.
Yes. And Dr. K.K. Patel sir for yes sir.
Yeah, audible.
Yes sir, as I have worked with GMERS hospital Dharpur, I know the need of quality is very much required for healthcare infrastructure. And this was the wonderful and very informative session for us. And thank you sir for organizing this wonderful webinar.
Thank you very much, sir. I am very much thankful to Dr. Meena sir. Sir, we are very much thankful to you for sparing your valuable time on this Saturday is a holiday, but you are now in the office and you spared lots of time for our students as well as the government officials. Sir, we will try our best to support the overall authority also, whatever work assigned by you. And I am very much thankful to you sir for sparing your valuable time. And I am very much to thankful to the government authority for developing such a valuable scheme for the people, providing a healthcare financing to the citizen of India. And doing well, PMJY is doing well in India, and lots of people are beneficiaries of this scheme, and more are benefiting out of that. So we are very much thankful to you and authorities of the government of India, sir. I am also very much thankful to Dr. Kartik Shah for providing his valuable time. He was busy, he was out of station, but he joined and provided us his valuable inputs to us. I am very much thankful to all participants. Constantly, I was the dashboard. Constantly, 55 participants are constantly joined and actively participated in this webinar. I am also very much thankful to Honorable Vice Chancellor Professor J.J. Vora sir for providing his valuable views, as well as presidential address and encouraging us to organize a webinar on this topic. And I am very much thankful to our registrar, Dr. D.M. Patel sir, for his valuable support to the department for organizing this webinar. On behalf of Department of Hospital Management, we are very much thankful to you, sir, and thank you very much. Any audience would like to raise the question if there are many hospital administrators are joined with us. So if they do have a problem, you can discuss with the Neena sir, even Karthik sir, and you can sort out if you are having a issues regarding a certification process in your mind. So we are, sir, very much thankful to you, Meena sir, once again. Jai Hind. आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद सर.
अच्छा, मेरा थोड़ा सा कुछ कहना है. सबसे पहले तो
हाँ जी सर
मैं पटेल साहब, बोरा साहब को खूब खूब धन्यवाद देना चाहूंगा कि आप मेरी अपॉर्चुनिटी थोड़ा थोड़ा ले लेते हो अभी.
नहीं सर,
गुजरात का नाम आता है, जब भी गुजरात का नाम आता है, पाटन यूनिवर्सिटी का आता है, तो मेरे को टाइम देना ही पड़ता है.
नहीं सर, थैंक यू सर.
अच्छा, दूसरा मैं सबसे रियली अपना जो स्टेट क्वालिटी एश्योरेंस टीम है, डॉक्टर साहा जिसको अपने लीड कर रहे हैं अभी, डॉक्टर साहा, दीप्ति, वैशाली, चंद्रेश, मैंग, आई हार्टली कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशन कि उन लोगों ने इसको कंटिन्यूसली इम्प्रूवमेंट किया. कभी कहते हैं कि कुछ लोग जाने के बाद थोड़ा डाउन होता है, लेकिन यहाँ तो उल्टा हुआ, जाने के बाद बहुत ज्यादा आगे बढ़े, तो वो एक सबसे अच्छी बात है. और कोई भी प्रोग्राम सक्सेस तभी होता है जब आपको जाने के बाद पता लगे कि वो सक्सेस हो रहा है.
तो
मैं रियली खूब खूब धन्यवाद देना चाहूंगा. और मेरे को जहां तक समझ में आता है कि शायद गुजरात की हर जगह क्वालिटी की नस्ल हो चुकी है, क्योंकि कंटिन्यूस क्वालिटी इंप्रूवमेंट की जब बात करें तो वहाँ गुजरात के हर जगह, जैसे धार में अभी पलक आए हैं, वहां पर हर मेडिकल कॉलेज हो या डिस्ट्रिक्ट हॉस्पिटल हो या PSC, कहीं ना कहीं क्वालिटी का एक बीज जो है वो उग चुका है और वो धीरे धीरे बड़ा भी हो रहा है. तो ये एक बहुत अच्छी बात है. और आप यूनिवर्सिटी उसमें साथ में बीच बीच में कुछ पानी डालने का काम कर रही है, तो वो इम्प्रूवमेंट हो सकता है. तो थैंक यू वेरी मच आप सब लोगों के लिए. और जब भी मेरा टाइम आपको जरूरत हो, 100% वी आर अवेलेबल 24/7.
Your valuable inputs will be useful to us, and department is always ready to help the healthcare sector wherever it is necessary. So hope for the best, and I wish good health to everybody on this pandemic situation, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you, sir.
हा મૌલિક ભાઈ, હા હવે પૂરું થઈ ગયું છે. બંધ કરો.